Good day, my wonderful children. How are you? Okay. The subject we have today is mathematics, and the topic is HCF, highest common factor. Before we continue, let's do a recap of what we have learned earlier, that's on LCM. On LCM, we said LCM is lowest or least common multiples. Least common multiple, LCM. That is the least of all the common multiples of given numbers. The least of all the common multiples of given numbers. And we said multiples are the numbers, multiples of a number. Multiples of a number is or are all the numbers that a given number can divide. Multiples of a number are all the numbers that a given number can divide without a remainder. Without a remainder. And we said to find multiples of a number. To find the multiples of a number, you write the number first. You write the number first, then to get the subsequent multiples, you will get the subsequent multiples by adding the number to itself or by multiplication. By adding the number to itself or by multiplication. And we also said to find lowest common multiple of a number or given numbers. You can find it by looking for the common multiples of the given numbers. Or you can find the lowest common multiple of given numbers by using prime number division method. Then we say common multiples common multiples of given numbers are the numbers that given numbers can divide. Common multiples of a number or common multiple of two numbers are the number that two given numbers can divide without a remainder. Without a remainder. The common multiples of those numbers, the numbers can divide them without a remainder. And we also make to know that prime number is a number that is only divisible by one and itself. The number that is divisible by one and itself is a prime number. And we listed examples of this prime number that I said you should put them at heart. We said one is not a prime number because no other number can divide one except one. And a prime number is a number that can divide itself. And one that is divisible by one and itself, that you can only use one to divide it and itself, no other number can go in it. We said examples of prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, and so on and so forth, 17, 19, that we should put at least this first number before 20. If the numbers before 20, the prime numbers between 1 and 20, you should put them at us, okay? And we are able to get our lowest common multiples using the two methods. But today, we'll be going further to HCF. At the end of the lesson, each of the pupils should be able to find factors of numbers. Find the highest common factor by picking the highest factor. And find the highest common factor by using the prime factor method. What is HCF? HCF means highest common factor. It is the largest or biggest factor in a series of factors. The biggest or the largest factor in a series. Series means more than one factor in a series of factors. Finding HCF, there are two methods to find HCF. There are two methods to find highest common factor of given numbers. Number one, by picking highest factor. Number two, by using prime factor method, also called the short division method. Finding highest common factor by picking the highest factor. We have done factors. We have done how to find factors of a given number in one of our lessons in second term. But we are going to do a recap so that we will be able to bring it to our remembrance, how to find factors of a number. Now, factors of a number are numbers that can divide the given number. Factors of a number are all the numbers that can divide a given number without a remainder. Means all those numbers are its factors. All those numbers that can divide the given number without a remainder. Means all those factors are its factors. All those numbers are its factors. Example, factors of 8. We'll learn this, that you draw a line, you put your 8, you put your 8 at the right hand side, and you pick the first number on the number line, on the number system. The first number of the number system is 1. The next one is 2. So you don't start with 1, you start with the next one after 1, which is 2. How many times will I see 2 in 8? I will see it 4 times. I will not stop at that. I will not say, still use 2 because 2 can still go in 4. How many times will I see 2 in 4? I will see it 2 times. I will not stop because I've not got to 1. I will only stop if I have got to 1. Now, how many times will I see 2 in 2? I will see it once. Now, the factors are, remember how we did this? We said the factors are, you start from 1, the smallest number that you can see, 1. You go to the upper part, you pick 2. If there's any other number among the numbers that you have used to divide, you pick it. But in this case, we have just 2. We have only made use of 2. Now, you would multiply 2 by the second 2. It will give us 4. You multiply 4 by the remaining 2, it will give us 8. Now, these are the factors of 8. 1, 2, 4, and 8. Factors of 12. You write 12. How many times do you see 2 in 12? 6 times. Are you going to stop? No, because you have not got to 1. How many times do you see 2 in 6? That's 3 times. I will not use 2 because 2 is not a perfect number for 3, to divide 3. We must pick a perfect number on the number system that will not give a remainder. Now go to the next one, which is 3, after 2 on the number system. The next number is 3. How many times will 3 go in 3? That is once. Then I will stop because I've got to 1. The factors are 1, 2, I have 3, get 3. I'll multiply 2 and 2 to give me 4. 2 multiplied by 3 to give me 6. Then I will multiply 2 times 2 times 3, which will give me 12. The factors of 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. Now, another method that you can use to find factors of a number is using multiplication method. Find the factors of 12. Begin by multiplying two numbers, starting with 1. You say 1 times 2, 12. 2 times 6, 12. 3 times 4, 12. If I move to 5, what can I multiply by 5 to give me 12? Oh, nothing. Then I will stop at 4. To pick my factors, I will start with the smallest number, 1. Move to 2, then to 3. Come to 4. Then go to 6, and I have the last one there as 12. Factors of 9. I will start my multiplication with the smallest number of the number system, which is 1. What can I multiply by 1 to give me 9? That is still 9, 1 times 9. I'll move to the next one, 2. What can I multiply by 2 to give me 9? That's not possible. I'll move to the next one, which is 3. What can I multiply by 3 to give me 9? That's 3 times 3. Oh, 9. I'll move to the next number in the number system, which is 4. What can I multiply by 4 to give me 9? Oh, there is no number. I'll stop at 3. Now, the factors are 1, 3, and 9. The factors are 1, 2, 3, and 9. 1, 2, 3, and 9. Now, let's go to the board in order to see this better. To find factors of a number. Factors of a number. 1, find the factors of 8. Find the factors of 8 using the division method. Using the division method, you draw a line. You put your 8 at the right side. You start with the lowest number on the number system. The lowest number on the number system after 1 is what? 2. Good. I'll write my 2. How many times will I see 2 in 8? Remember the way we normally do it. 2 times 1, 2. 2 times 2, 4. 2 times 3, 6. 2 times 4, 8. Oh, I've got to 8. How many times did I multiply 2? 4 times. I will see my 2 in 8 4 times. I will use 2 again because 2 is the perfect number to divide 4. How many times will I see 2 in 4? 2 times. I will not stop until when I get to 1. 2. How many times will I see 2 in 2? 1. Now, to write my factors out, the factors are 1. I'll move to the first one, 2. If there's any other number there that is different from the one that I've written down, I'll write it down as well. But in this case, we have 2 up through. I will now say 2 times 2, 4. If I say 2 times 2 again, it's still 4, and I've written 4 down, I will leave it at that. I will now say 4 times 2. 4 times 2 is 8. So the factors are 1, 2, and 8. 1, 2, 4, and 8 are the factors of 8. Now, going by multiplication method, find the factors. The factors of 12. Find the factors of 12 by multiplication method. We'll start with the lowest number on the number system. The lowest number on the number system is what? 1. Good. I'll say 1. What can I multiply by 1? To give me 12. What can I multiply by 1 to give me 12? What can I multiply by 1 to give me 12? What can I multiply by 1 to give me 12? That is 12. So I'll say 1 times 12, which is equal to what? 12. I'll move to the next number in the number system. The next number in the number system is 2 after 1. Then I'll say, what can I multiply by 2 to give me 12? That's 2 times 6. The next number is 3. What can I multiply by 3 to give me 12? 3 times 4. The next number on the number system is 4. What can I multiply by 4 to give me 12? That is still 3, and I've written that. I don't need to repeat. Now, the next number is 5. What can I multiply by 5 to give me 12? Oh, nothing. I will stop at that. Now, to get my factors out, I will start with the lowest number. 1, 2, 3. Are you looking at the screen? 3. Then I have 4, 6, and 12. And 12. Can you see that this one is like simpler? This is simpler than the one that we have been using, the division method. Let's try and adopt this. Try by multiplying the numbers, starting with the lowest number on the number system, by a number to give me the given number. And so on and so forth until you get to where you cannot multiply any number by it. Now write the numbers out, starting from the lowest. Coming down, you come down, then go to the other side, take it up until you get to the number itself. To get the factors. Should we try one more? Yes. Should we try one more? 9. Find the factors of 9. Find the factors of 9 using multiplication method. I will start with the lowest number in the number system, which is 9, which is 1. 1 times 9 will give me 9. I'll move to the next number on the number system, and that is 2. What can I multiply by 2 to give me 9? Is anything? Oh, no. I'll move to the next one, which is 3. What can I multiply by 3 to give me 9? That is 3 times 3, which is equals to 9. I'll move to the next number, 4. What can I multiply by 4 to give me 9? Oh, nothing. Let me stop at this. Then to get the numbers out, I have told you to start with the lowest number. The factors are 1, 3, 1, 3, 3 is here again. I don't need to repeat. Then I'll take it up. And 9. These are the factors of 9. These are the factors of 9. Assignment will be given to you on factors. Try and use this division method. It is simpler. Try and use the division method. Okay? So on getting these factors now, we have been able to get factors. We have learned how to get factors now. So let's move to getting factors for given numbers. Get factors for given numbers. Find the HCM of the following numbers by picking the highest factor. Find the HCM of given numbers by picking the highest factors. Find the HCM of 12 and 16. First, find the factors of the given numbers. The factors of 12. Remember, I've said we'll be using the division method. We start by multiplying with the lowest number in the number system, which is 1. So we have 1 times 12 to give us 12. Then you move to the next number on the number system, which is 2. What can I multiply by 2 to give me 6? And that's 2 times 6, 12. I'll move to the next number on the number system, which is 3. What can I multiply by 3 to give me 12? That's 3 times 4. Okay? The next number, 4. 4 times 3. So I don't need to repeat since I've written 3 times 4 down. The next number is 5. What can I multiply by 5 to give me 12? Nothing. I will stop at that. Now, the factors are 1, then 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. The same thing you will do. The same method you apply to 16. What can I multiply by 1 to give me 16? That's 1 times 16. What can I multiply by 2 to give me 16? 2 times 8. What can I multiply by 3 to give me 16 is not possible. What can I multiply by 4 to give me 16? That's 4 times 4. I will stop at that because 5 cannot be multiplied by any number to give me 16 perfectly. So I will have the factors as 1, 2, 4. 4 is already there, I don't need to repeat. 8 and 16. Now, common factors are the numbers that are common. The numbers that are common in the two given numbers or in the given numbers. Number that you can see in the first one and is appearing in the second one, you circle the number. What are the numbers that we can see in 12 and you can as well see it in 16? That's 1. I've circled my own. Try and circle your own as I am circling my own. We have 1. We also have 2. We have 3. We have, no, sorry, we have 1. 1 is in among the factors of 12 and is among the factors of 16. 2 is among the factors of 12 and is among the factors of 16. 4 is among the factors of 12 and is among the factors of 16. Is there any other number that you can see in the two numbers? That's among the factors that you can see that is appearing up and is appearing down? No. So common factors are 1, 2, and 4. Highest common factor, the largest, the biggest among these numbers is the highest common factor. Highest common factor is 4 because it's the highest factor among the common factors. Therefore, HCF of 12 and 16 is 4. Now let's go to the second method, finding HCF by prime factor method. Finding highest common factor by prime factor method. What is a prime factor? We have learned what a prime number is. A prime number is a number that is only divisible by 1 and itself. Now, what is a prime factor? A prime factor is a factor that is a prime number. A factor that is a prime number. You have gotten factors for given numbers. Among those factors that you have gotten or that you have got for the number, if there's anyone among those numbers that is a prime number, then that number is a prime factor among the factors. A prime factor is a factor that is a prime number. We have said a prime number is a number that is only divisible by 1 and itself. Okay? Now, after getting factors for a given number, if there is a prime number among the factors, then that factor is a prime factor because it is a prime number. Example, the prime factors of 12, means you would divide 12 by prime numbers. And I've just told you what prime numbers are. Examples of prime numbers, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19. For your level that you keep at heart. Now you pick the smallest one, among these prime numbers. The smallest one is 2. How many times will 2 go in 12? That's 6. How many times will 2 go in 12? 6. You will not stop at that until you get to 1. How many times will 2 go in 6? 3. I will not use 2 again because 2 is not a perfect number to divide 3. Now I will move to the next prime number, which is 3. How many times will 3 go in 3? 1. The numbers that I'll be able to use, the prime numbers that I'll be able to use, are the prime factors of 12. These are 2, and 3, 2, 2, and 3. So you multiply the prime numbers together to get the prime factors for 12. So therefore, you say 2 times 2 times 3. 2 times 2 will give us 4. 4 times 3 will give us 12. 4 times 3 will give us 12. That's how to get prime factors. Now, finding highest common factor by prime factor method. Find the HCF of 8 and 12. Find the prime factor of 8 first. Prime factors of 8. What are the numbers that can divide, the prime numbers that can divide 8 perfectly? Start with 2. We start with 2. How many times will 2 go in 8? 4 times. You will not stop at that until you get to 1. How many times will 2 go in 4? 2 times. How many times will 2 go in 2? 1. Then the prime factors of 8 are the prime numbers that you have used to divide 8. And they are 2 times 2 times 2. The prime factors of 12, the prime factors of 12 are the prime numbers that you can use to divide 12 perfectly. How many times will 2 go in 12? 6. How many times will 2 go in 6? 3. We can't use 2 because 2 is not a perfect number to divide 3. We'll go to the next prime number, which is 3. How many times will 3 go in 3? 1. The prime factors are the prime numbers that you have used, and they are 2 times 2 times 3. These are the prime factors of 12. Now, common factors are the numbers that you can see in both numbers. In both numbers, we can see 2 among the factors of 8, and we can as well see it in 12. We can see another 2, and we can see it as well in 12. These are the two numbers that we can see that are common, that are appearing in the two numbers among their factors. Now, common factors are 2 and 2. Common factors are 2 and 2. For AC health, in LCM, you pick the highest one. But for HCF, you multiply them together. So we have 2 times 2 to give you 4. 2 times 2 to give you 4. Let's go to the board. Now let's go to the board. Let's go to the board. To find the HCF using common factors. To find the HCF using common factors. To find the HCF using common factors, you find the factors. You find the factors of the given numbers. You find the factors of the given numbers. You find the factors of the given numbers. Find the factors of the given number. 1. Find the HCF of 8 and 12. Find the HCF of 8 and 12. Find the HCF of 8 and 12 using common factors. Using common factors. Using common factors. Using common factors. Now, I'll first find the factors of 8. Factors of 8 are the factors of 8. The factors of 8 are the factors of 8. I'll start by multiplying with the lowest number of the number system. 1 times 8, which is 8. I'll move to the next number of the number system, which is 2. And that's 2 times 4 will still give me 8. The next number of the number system is 3. What can I multiply by 3 to give me 8? Nothing. I will stop at this. Now, the factors are 1, 2, 4, and 8. And 8. Now, the factors of 12. The factors of 12. The factors of 12. The factors of 12. The factors of 12 are. The factors of 12. I'll start by multiplying with the lowest number of the number system. 1 times 12 is 12. 2 times 6 is 12. 3 times 4 is 12. I will stop at that. My factors are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. Now, the common factors. The common factors. The common factors are. The common factors are writing the factors of the numbers. The common factors are the factors of 12. 1, 2, 4, and 8. The factors of 8. Of 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. What are the factors that are common that you can see in the first number and you can as well see in the second number? What are the numbers that are common there? The factors that are common there. 1, 2, and 4. 1, 2, and 4. 1, 2, and 4. Now, the highest common factor there, the common factors are 2 and 4. The common factors are 2 and 4. Then the highest common, the highest there, is what? Are you saying 4? Good. Those are my wonderful children. Excellent children. 4. The highest. So therefore, ACF is equals to 4. ACF is 4. That is the highest among the common factors. Among the common factors. That's the highest. Then we said the second method is by using the prime factors division method. Using prime factor division method, which you have to find the factors separately. And how do you get your factors? Use your prime numbers to divide the given numbers separately, one after the other. Now write their factors out. That's the prime numbers that you have used to divide them. Unlike LCM, for LCM, we sum the numbers together. You have to draw a line or lines, putting the numbers in between the lines. And you use common prime number for the given numbers. But in HCF, you find the prime number, you divide with the prime number separately. You divide the prime number separately, then you bring it down. You bring it down. You bring it down, and you find the numbers that are common. After finding the numbers that are common, you multiply. You multiply. After finding the numbers that are common, you multiply. You know, even at LCM, we multiply the numbers, the prime numbers. But in the case of HCF, we are not dividing with the prime numbers of the two numbers at a go. We are dividing separately, bringing the prime numbers down. Now you circle it equally. As you can see on the screen, you circle it equally, then you multiply the numbers that you have circled. You multiply the numbers that you have circled as your highest common factor. As your highest common factor. Practice makes perfection. I've always said that. Practice makes perfection. Try and as much as possible to make sure you practice what we have learned. Make sure you watch the video, pay attention, and practice after watching the video. That is when it will become part and parcel of you. It will become part and parcel of you. By the time you practice the more, you work, you twist your fingers, work the solution to the questions, how, and you attempt the assignments. Make sure you attempt the assignments, then you will have a better understanding of what we are talking about. Try as much as possible to work. Don't play a word of time. Don't play a word of time. This time will so pass away. And we will so come back to the four-wall corner of the classroom. So do not lag behind. Make sure you are practicing what we are doing. And the good Lord will give you wisdom and understanding in Jesus' name. Have a nice day. Bye.